So for more on that, here's the General Manager of Worldwide Office Marketing, Julia White.
Hi.
You're welcome.
All right. It is great to be here, and hopefully I see some familiar faces from past years. But I wanted to spend this next set of time talking about how we see the future of productivity going, obviously mobile being a big piece of it, cloud obviously central to it as well, and just get a sense of kind of where we're heading, what we're investing towards, and the innovation areas that we are resourcing specifically. So I sit across the office division, so thinking about everything from office client, the apps on Windows, on Macs, on iPads, on Androids, everything in between, as well as all of the Office 365 services too. So kind of talk about that whole area when I'm speaking overall. And starting coming from Office and what people know and love, I want to start with the fact that the world has changed. And sometimes people think of Office and productivity as that Office 2007 thing you have on your PC that you haven't updated in a decade or so, and that's how you're working. And I'm here to say that is not how the world works now. It shouldn't be how you're working, and it's certainly not how we look at the world and how productivity works today. It's absolutely not sufficient to be able to keep up with the demands of the workplace that we have. So let me talk a little bit about what are those things? What are the areas we need to innovate and think about as we think about the future of productivity? First, something really critical is that we look at, the world's a giant network. If you think about very specifically in our personal lives. So I get probably 90% of my news off of Twitter. That's where I learn about all the breaking news. I keep up with my friends and family on Facebook. I get my next job on LinkedIn, other groups. And that's just how we run our personal lives. But it's also how we're redefining the work life as well. We should be together redefining the workspace as well. And it's not just about having networks and having information out there. That's not the point of a network. The real magic beneath this is the fact that the communications go from being closed by default, like we're used to an email and sitting on your hard drive, to open by default. That means when you put information out in the world or out in your organization, suddenly it's discoverable. Suddenly more people can benefit from that. And I think about how much information today sits in my personal inbox. Someone sent it to me, some group sent it to me, and it would be incredibly useful for other people in my organization to have access to that information. But they won't because it's sitting in my inbox. I could spam my whole organization with all my email, but that would be an unfortunate thing. So instead, all this interesting IP and relevant information that could be benefiting others in my org is inaccessible. So that's the paradigm we're trying to break. We know and love email, but it's closed. It's a closed metaphor. It's an important metaphor. Email's not dead. I've been doing this for 10 years. People told me that 10 years ago. It's not. But it's insufficient. And we need to think about how to evolve into open, collaborative, discoverable communication experiences. And you'll see as we're doing that, we're putting more and more open communication paradigms into familiar places, like bringing open conversations into Outlook, something we're working on and something we've just started releasing in Office 365. So getting people a comfortable way to move between the very familiar email into something that is more useful and relevant for your organization. You can find things more that you need, you can discover them, you can make better decisions. And the model I like to think about too is something as we think about what we're building and how we allocate our engineering resources and what we do, this is one of my favorite models. So we have a Office 365 education offering, and so we spend a lot of time with students, K through 12, as well as higher ed around the globe. And just looking at how they work, what their habits are, what are those habits that they bring into the workplace? What expectations do they have? What would be applicable to the workplace and what wouldn't, and all of that in between. And one of my most favorite recent examples, we were working with a high school, and we're on site looking, watching them work and watching some of the students do their work in the classroom. And one of the guys on my team asked one of the students and said, "Hey, do you ever save anything local? Like on your PC, save something local." And the high school student actually looked at him and said, "What's that mean?" And fair question, what does that mean? Save local, it's not a concept they'd held to deal with. They have my mobile phone. I don't save local on my mobile phone. That's not a concept that made sense to them. And then the better question that the student then asked after we explained what we meant was, "Why would I do that?" Another good question. Why would you do that? The minute you save something local, then you're tied to one device. right? If it's only on my Mac, it's only on my PC, it's only on my iPad, I'm only productive there. So a key piece of being able to move to this new metaphor, have the open communications, is also the fact that you're not tied to any one device. Your content can't sit there, or you're only productive there, and that is absolutely insufficient. So the content, all of your content needs to be somewhere where you can access it across every device you have. And something we, of course, take for granted in email, right? Every device I pick up, I can access my email, but we don't have that same absolute fundamental expectation of all of our work's content, and we need to. That's why it's actually really hard these days to buy a copy of Office Client without cloud storage with it. OneDrive's just a piece of that. That's where you need to, those things go together. You shouldn't be breaking those apart because it's so fundamental to being able to be productive. It's about the user being mobile and being able to move across my devices and have access to everything I need. It's not about any one of my devices. So really fundamental, that piece. Also, as you look at students too, definitely always connected. I'm kind of always sharing, always collaborative, connected with the cloud, but also connected with each other and having that just as a work style. And I think about, like, I can't actually remember the last time that I went in my office and long form wrote something all by myself and then mailed it out to people. That's not how work gets done. That's not how the best ideas are germinated. It's about, I have an idea. I think I have some good ideas. I have some pieces of information I pulled together, and I share it out so people can add to it. They can collaborate on it. We can iterate it. We can be very, very rapid in how we do that. I have a germination of idea, but I need this sense of, you know, subject matter expertise and wisdom around me, and that's how work gets done. That's how schoolwork's getting done. That's how workplace work also needs to be done to get the best decisions. So really tap into the broader IQ of your whole organization. Again, and the underpinnings of that are, things are shared openly. Things are collaborative by default. They're not locked to any one machine or any one person. It's an essence of the organization knowledge. And that's the mindset. And that's the kind of tools we're looking to build or have built and continue to build is really of this kind of work style. So just to make it real for a second, this is actually a picture of an office, Microsoft Office in Germany. And just to kind of give you, not only is it the technology, but it's also the physical space too, and bringing those together to really unlock this kind of called ubiquitous collaboration, that everything by design, by default, is a kind of a collaborative experience. And you have folks kind of working in small groups together, and that's very effective. You have people working with someone across the globe, interacting. Maybe they're on their beanbag by themselves, but they're actually interacting and working on content with folks across the globe. And then, of course, working across different device sizes, from the very, very largest, like that big PPI screen, to their phone in their pocket and everything in between. And that combination of both kind of physical workspace, but also the technology and the behaviors of sharing openly by default, saving things to the clouds, you have access across devices, default having a collaborative experience in everything you do, that, we believe, is not only how we could be working today, but how everyone will be working in the future. And the technologies we're building around OneDrive for cloud storage with 1 terabyte of storage right now, and that's only getting bigger, allowing you to put whatever you might need in the cloud so you can have access across it. Things like Yammer and Enterprise Social, a bunch of different areas that come into play in the space, but it's overall a work behavior that we think about on that front.